Suppose you have some data, say the height and weight of people, or the size and price of houses, or whatever. The canonical summary statistics for such multivariate data are the mean and the covariance. But what if, instead, you have a set of entities and your data are their pairwise connections? That is, you have a network. How might you summarize the structure of such connections in a similarly principled way?
Hi there, my name is Jessia, and I will introduce you to graph cumulants, the principal extension of cumulants to networks. This work is in collaboration with my husband, Lee Gunderson, with emotional support provided by the esteemed Ashley Maria Bravo Gunderhamsdorff.
And all three of us hope you enjoy it. Imagine a world without the notion of variance. How would one summarize the spread in their data? People would, and indeed people have, come up with different methods for quantifying the spread of a distribution. This is essentially the current state of network science. Proposed summary statistics are as diverse as the networks they intend to describe, and a standardized hierarchy has not yet been established. So, why should graph cumulants provide this standardized hierarchy? First, the definitions are principled. Being analogous to the classical cumulants, they inherit many of their desirable properties. Second, their interpretations are intuitive. For example, when used in motif analysis, graph cumulants really capture the notion of the propensity or aversiveness of a network to display a particular substructure. Lastly, the procedure is general, offering such a measure of propensity for any substructure of interest, including those with additional features such as edge weights, directed edges, and node attributes. Let us first address the notion of the propensity of a network to display a specific substructure. Why is the clustering coefficient so popular? Instead of the fraction of wedges that form a triangle, why not simply use the fraction of three nodes that form a triangle? In dividing by the wedges, essentially incomplete triangles, the clustering coefficient attempts to account for the appearance of smaller substructures. But what if you're interested in, say, this substructure, the triangle with an edge? What do you do now? Do you divide by the triangles, the clause, the path graph with three edges? Wouldn't it be nice if one could somehow account for all these possibilities in a principal way? This is precisely what cumulants do. Some of you may be familiar with the following definition of cumulants. They are the coefficients in the form of a series of the logarithm of the expectation of the exponential of the product of the form variable and your random variable. But forget about that. Instead, we are going to use an equivalent combinatorial definition, one that's a bit more hands-on. To get the kth cumulant, consider all the ways you can partition k unique objects. Here, k is 2, and we can partition in two different ways. Both objects together, and each object separate. These correspond to a relationship between the second moment on the left and the first and second cumulants on the right. The first cumulant is easy. It's simply the mean itself. Substituting the top equation into the bottom, we can rearrange to get the familiar expression for the variance. Let's do one more. For the third moment, we can partition in three ways. All three objects together, each object separate, and two objects together and one separate. But be careful! I said unique objects. There are actually three ways to split into groups of size 1 and 2. So we put a 3 here. Substituting again, we obtain the third cumulant, also known as the skew.
For networks, we replace these colored circles with edges. The moments of a subgraph, denoted here by expectation, indicates the density of the subgraph. That is, the counts of the subgraph in the network divided by its counts if there were edges between all pairs of nodes in the network. When partitioning the edges of the subgraph, we must now respect their connectivity. For example, when all three edges are in the same group, they inherit the full connectivity of the subgraph. When all three edges are in different groups, there is no information about their relative connectivity. The intermediate term is a bit tricky. As before, there are three ways to split the edges into groups of size 1 and 2. In two cases, the groups with two edges has them sharing a node, and in one case, the group with two edges has them not sharing any node. Substituting and rearranging, we obtain the graph cumulant for the path graph of length 3. One of the popular methods for motive analysis is to compare the subgraph counts in the observed network to those obtained from a model that mimics its degree distribution. To compare this method with ours, we sampled networks from a symmetric stochastic block model with two well-separated communities, arguably the simplest model that displays clustering. The motif profile resulting from such a method looks something like this. It may seem that this method correctly identifies that substructures with close paths are favored by the network. However, we argue that our method correctly singles out only the simple closed paths. Indeed, as the stochastic block model with symmetric communities lacks correlation between node degrees, the three like components appears essentially at random, and Occam's razor should shave away these graphical whiskers. Moreover, our method remains robust when decreasing the separation between the two communities. So, these plots were made by averaging the results for many networks, all sampled from the same stochastic block model. However, often one has only a single observed network. In sharp contrast to the configuration model, our method is able to quantify the uncertainty, all without the need to sample from a new model, a process that's typically computationally intensive and often straight up infeasible. The framework laid out in this video naturally extend to networks with additional features, such as directed edges, node attributes, and edge weights. Moreover, this framework can assign quantities to individual nodes and edges, with applications to node classification and link prediction. Currently, we have projects on applying graph cumulants too, solving the degeneracy problem of exponential random graph models, and testing statistical similarities of networks. If any of these topics interest you, please don't hesitate to reach out.